Let's create a poster with simple 3D elements using Blender and Inkscape. Open Blender and select General. You have a scene now. Middle click and drag to rotate the scene. Rotate your mouse wheel to zoom. The default cube is already selected. Let's delete it by using the delete button. Now go to Add Mesh Torus. We are creating a basic donut-like shape. Click the torus, press G and then Z to move the torus on the Z axis. Drag the mouse and click to place it. Press R and drag the mouse to rotate. Then click to place it. Press G and Z to move it on the Z axis again. Let's give this torus a material. Go to Material and click New. Change the base color. Give it a shade of purple. You can preview the material here. Or here using Render View. To make the torus look smooth, we'll add a modifier. Modifier Subdivision Surface. Press Shift and drag the mouse while middle clicking to pan the area. Right click and duplicate the object. Drag the mouse and click to place it in a different spot. Press R and move the mouse to rotate and click to place it. If you want to rotate in X or Y axis, press R and then X or Y and drag the mouse. Repeat the same for some more toruses. Now add a light by going to Add Light Area. It is pointing downwards. Rotate by pressing R and moving the mouse to point it upwards. Go to Light Properties and change the power to around 150 watts. You can see in the render preview that the light is casting from below. Let's change the color and size of it. Duplicate the light by right-clicking and then press Z and drag the mouse to move it straight upwards. Press R to rotate and point it downwards. Let's change the light color and power. Now go to View, Align View, Align Active Camera to View. This makes the output look as it is shown to us in the screen. Now we have to adjust the camera to make objects be inside of the camera view. For that, select the camera and move it in the X axis by pressing G and X and dragging the mouse. Left click to place it. Now move it in the Y direction. Objects. Now the objects are inside the camera frame. Before exporting the image, we have to make the background transparent. For that, go to Render Properties, Film, and check Transparent. Now go to Render, Render Image. You can see the rendered image. Save the image by going to Image, Save As, and save it using the PNG format. Now close out of Blender, open Inkscape, go to Document Properties and give it a size of around 1200 by 1600. Import the exported image from Blender. Let's keep it aside for a while and turn on snapping. Draw a rectangle and give it a purple color. Bring the image and resize it to fit the poster. Let's change the image properties a bit. Go to Filters, Color, Color Shift, and change only the saturation and make the color shift to 0. Go to Filters, Color, Lightness and Contrast, and change the values to fit your preferences. Duplicate the background and give it a border and remove the fill. Now select the text tool and type something. Change the font to Inter and resize it. Make sure to hold Ctrl and Shift to lock proportions while resizing. Send it backwards and then one step forward. Duplicate the text and give it a blur and send it backwards. Change its color accordingly. Duplicate the text again and type different words to make the background more rich. Give it a light color and do this multiple times. Select all and align them. Group them and place it on the poster and send it backwards and then one step forward. Duplicate the background and select the text group by holding Shift to select both. Right click, set clip. Now I'll add some final touches with some text. You can export the page now. Hope you enjoyed. Please don't forget to like and subscribe.